So, welcome everybody, and thank you for joining us tonight on this, our lovely Tuesday meeting. It's a nice and intimate one today, which I love. Before we get started with the talk, we're going to sing one hymn together. Hopefully it's one that everybody knows. And what we want to do now is we're going to basically get a split. If you don't know this hymn, you're about to learn it because it's a nice and very easy one, and we'll sing it all together on the count of three. We can. Let's try. One, two, three.
Echerestos anesti
alethos
anesti.
Christ is risen.
He is truly
Jesus, the compassionate,
was crucified too.
Jesus, the compassionate,
was crucified too.
To redeem the human race
from the fortress of Satan. Echerestos
anesti
alethos
anesti.
Christ is risen.
Truly he is risen.
After 3 days,
while it was dark.
Sleeping,
Christ is risen.
Echerestos anesti,
Christ is risen.
Truly risen.
The disciples were afraid,
and the soldiers were standing.
The disciples were afraid,
and the soldiers were standing.
Marys were coming.
They found that Christ is risen. Echerestos
anesti
alethos
anesti.
Christ is risen.
He is truly risen.
The disciples of Jesus, disciples of Jesus, wipe the tears.
Christ is risen. Echerestos
anesti
alethos
anesti. Truly risen.
How beautiful a thing.
The glorious Easter.
How beautiful a thing.
The glorious Easter.
And every Sunday feast.
Christ is risen. Echerestos anesti alethos
anesti. Christ is risen. He is It's a nice energetic hymn, that one. Always gets me fired up, not going to lie. But we're not here to talk about how much I love that hymn. We're here to talk about something else tonight. So tonight we're actually starting off a new theme. The theme for this next 4 weeks is looking at steadfastness versus instability. And in order to really understand steadfastness and instability, we thought, what better way than to explore the parables, the very teachings of our Lord Christ? So we're going to kick off with the first one tonight being the parable of the sower. And so I'm going to ask Deacon to come forward now and to share with us a word.
So with the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, let's contemplate we're starting a new series. This is what I knew. Okay? So let's contemplate with the first session probably of your series, which is the parable of the sower. So the before we start, so we're starting a new series. So was the simplest thing for our Lord Jesus Christ to explain everything? It's the simplest thing in general to explain anything for anyone in a story or in an example. Is that right? So because people were very simple, even if any one of you a teacher and you have some students, so you explain for them, and if it's not working, you explain another way and give examples and give stories and so on until you whatever you want them to understand, they will get it. And this is the same way our Lord Jesus Christ is doing, and this is the same way the church followed. You know, in the month of Hathor, the gospel of the first Sunday and the second Sunday, actually two, the same thing, we read it, the same parable in the first and the second weeks of Hathor. So why? Because the church followed the same. You know, this month of Hathor is the beginning of the plantations in Egypt in this time. So they used to just to simplify. So this from there, they used to connect the readings and the spiritual life with their normal life. So they remember. So they were connected with what they are doing actually in this time, which they were planting and farming in this starting of this season. And this is the same, which is the, as I'm saying, the church followed the same idea. So let's see, which is, it reminds me, the parable itself, who is trying the same seeds, the same source, the same farmer or the sower. But what is different is different lands. It's like, reminds me of the scientific experiment. Did you study all of this? And controlled variables, independent variables, dependent variables. You remember all of this? And you studied it in year 8 and year 9. Anyone of you? So this is exactly. So we have the controlled variables, which is the sower is the same. Is that right? In all cases, the seeds are the same. So what is the independent variable? Exactly. Which is different grounds, which is resembles to different hearts or different stages of life, which is different persons, okay? And the dependent variable is the, you're seeing different effect in different heart. Is that right? That's the dependent one, which is the result of this change you're doing in your independent variables. Am I too much scientific? No, let's move on to from the scientific experiment into a spiritual experiment. Different hearts and different responses to the same word, to the same seeds, but different reaction. Is that right? Because everyone is different. But not here. To be fair, so no one can have any excuse, because the sower knows that the seeds which is fold, however it's fold, it didn't mean to fall, but he meant to spread his seeds in all these different grounds, so no one has an excuse. However, he knows it's not, but just to be fair. So he meant to give it or to spread it. However, he knows all these different, however, he is very experienced. That's his job, and he knows, but he didn't abandon anyone from his word. Is that clear at this point? Okay, however, it's different, but he didn't abandon any one of these different grounds too. That reminds me of something else. You know the seismometer? Did you, anyone? What is that seismometer? What is this? Is a device for earthquakes, measuring and recording any changes in the stability of the earthquake. Because this will take us to the stability and instability as well. Okay? And it shows any changes. Exactly, this can show us these four different types of grounds. So the first one, which is the parable, all of you, or should we read it? I just, to save time, I jumped straight, but I can see that it's in front of you. So it is four different grounds. So the first one, which can show is like the wayside, or is that right? The wayside, it shows like a flat. If you want to put it in a graph, okay, or a wave shape, it's like flat. No change. Is that right? No depth, no plant at all, no nothing. No hazza, you know? No wave at all. The second one shows a little plant started to grow, but there is no depth, there is no root, so it's a little wave. The third type, which is that's the rocky one, the third one was just thorny ground, is showed a little bit higher, because there is a little bit more depth, but the thorns killed it. Is that right? So that. How about the last one? Showed like a big shake, a big normal wave. That was a seismometer. And it reminds me as well with the ECG as well, the heart's responses to this machine and how it shows if there is issues. But that's, I think, much better example, the seismometer. It shows that somebody is the world affecting or is doing nothing like the first one. Let's go through them in a little bit more depth in each of them and see what are these different types of hearts or different types of grounds. So the first one, which is the wayside. The wayside, you know, the wayside in any field, it's a little bit in the middle, it's a way. It's not for planting at all. So it's just for people to walk on. Is that right? So it's a little elevated. A little, sometimes they put some gravel and some, is that what they do? So it's a little bit elevated than the normal ground. Is that right? So it's elevated, and that's the issue. The issue is this type of heart. It's a bit arrogant. Thinks that he is the one. He's the one who knows everything. I know, and when you talk with this type of heart or of person, don't talk, and you're going to give me a sermon? Oh, I know, don't talk with me. I know everything. This reminds me with a story happened with St. Anthony. One day, he was just passing by, and there was a group of the fathers sitting and discussing a spiritual matter or a biblical matter. And this was about Melchizedek. And one of them, he's the high priest. And another one is saying so and so, and he is, and he is. And another one saying, oh no, it's the appearance of the son. He is a resemble of this, and so on. It's a bit complicated. And Saint Anthony stopped and asked one of the monks in this time. His name was Abba Yusuf. And he said, what do you think, Abba Yusuf, about this matter the father's discussing? And he said to him, believe me, Father, I don't know. Saint Anthony straight, he said, blessed you are, Abba Yusuf, because you knew the way to the word, I don't know. It's not many of us, they have this humble heart, which is allowed to the word of God to work in. Because the word of God to work and to be stable in this heart needs a humble heart. But this one, which I know, okay, you know, so you don't need. Is that right? You don't need, but it works only in the one who feels really that he in need. Feels really that he is like nothing, and I do need him. So this is a critical matter. This is this type of heart is a bit hard. And hard for anything to happen. It's no plant even, not even a little plant, like the other. Three, this is the one actually doesn't have any plant at all because of this elevation or arrogance. So it's like, you know, like a way. Everyone is stepping on it. Everyone is following. Anyone says a word, any fashion, why not? We'll do this. And the word of God is what will be snatched by the Satan, the birds. It's not going to have any. So that's the issue. That's very hard. Okay? So it's just, has no opinion, has nothing. It's following any wind of anything, following this fashion. It's something new or any word. It has no values, has no clear directions or clear life or clear understanding of the deep meaning of life. That's the one. So has no readiness for anything. Why I'm saying this word? Because this will take us to the second type, which is showing a little bit of response. Little, small plant. So the second one is saying what? Rocky, but has a small layer of soil, which allows to the plant to a little to start growing. But once the sun, saying what? Rocky ground, where it did not have much earth, soil. And immediately it sprang up because it had no depth of earth. And when the sun was up, it was coast will die. Is that right? That's which is resembles to it start growing, showing some plants. So at least it has something. But the problem doesn't have this much readiness to grow, to enjoy more. The priests come, I'm going to go to the church, spend an hour, socialize, and have a good word. So, maybe I'll say Abuna, I'll say hi, or I'll go and attend the liturgy. That's it. All what I can give them. But during the week, no, thank you. I went to the church on Sunday. I spent an hour in the meeting. Nothing more? No. That's what he is readiness. It's I have a little bit of readiness, but it's limited. Doesn't want to give more. And this is the problem. Because, or showing a little bit of religious behavior, you know? A little bit of religious behavior. But once the sun comes, what's going to happen? will appear on his, will die, will complain and blaspheme and why God is doing this to me and so on. You're just was showing just superficial religious actions. And now you're complaining and blaspheming and so on because there were no depth. And once the sun come, and the sun, like the temptations, the issues of life, and so on, it will show the real person under, that there is no depth, there is no stability. Okay? So that's the second one. So the main issue or the main parameter for us, it's still showing some plant, but the main parameter for us, does he show some fruits or not? And this is our, when we judge, we'll judge if there is, because the second and the third, we'll see in the third that there is some plants, but it's not the issue about the plants, so showing some nice attitude, a little bit religious, but this is not the parameter. This is not the main sign to tell us if this is the right thing or not. Okay, so we'll see. And even if we just go back to this stony, it's stones which is can take us to. See this type of heart is worshiping the stones and too many stones around us. Money are stones or rank or whatever. All of this worldly stuff are stones, okay, which is stops us from growing, stops us from having deep root in him because takes us away from him. This is the issue with this type. So if there was there no depth, it because it had no root, it would withered away. The third one, which is the thrones, and this is can you know the problem with this type, which is grows in middle of the thrones. The thrones normally is very strong plants and takes most of the any water or anything. So it does affect any plant growing next to it. It's so tough. So it's very hard for any plants to grow next to the thrones. And that's the issue here. And the thrones, the fathers, they explain it by three things, actually. They say there are three different types of thrones around us. The first one, when we worry a lot, worrying about money or worrying about life or family or married or not or this or that, this is too much. You just worry and busy thinking about what I'm going to do today, what I'm going to do tomorrow, what is going to happen, and the world is just taking us from day to day until. So, and all of this on account of our spiritual life. That's the thrones. So it's like not giving any chance for us to grow spiritually. You know what I mean? Taking all the richness, all the food from us. Second one, which is the wealth. Some will say, why not? It's good to be rich and to spend here. It's good. We didn't say it's right. But when this richness and wealth take us away and become it's the main thing I'm running behind, that's the problem. So we're not saying the problem in the thing itself. The issue not in the fire, but how to use the fire. The issue not in the money, but how to use the money. So it's not, we don't have halal and haram or whatever, but we have right and is it lawful to do it or not? Is that if we use the money or the fire to burn somebody, that's a wrong thing. But if you use it for boiling something or warming something, that's a, so that's the problem with how to use the things. The same with the money. How do we use the money? Is the money controlling you or are you controlling it? And so it's a gift. We can't question. The money is a gift from God, but how to use this gift? Is that taking it from him or taking you closer to him? And this is the rule applied in many things. Okay? So using it for serving God or it's using you to serve itself. The third one, which is the first saying about the thrones, it resembles to the when we get busy with the desires and of the world, like eating and drinking and entertaining. So this is at the same point, when you come, how about what's wrong? It's good to eat a nice food. It's good to drink some good drink or entertain. Why not? We didn't say no. But when it comes as a priority for you, just living for eating and drinking and entertaining and what we're going to do tomorrow, what we're going to travel to this next week and what we do, this is the issue. It's good to have, but you have to be watching. You have to watch what is happening. Is that taking you away? Is that the priority? Or what is your priorities? You know what I mean? But there's no harm to eat a nice food. It's no harm. It's good. Is that right? So, but the problem with the priorities. That's the issue. So that's the three different. So Saint Cyril the Great, he's saying what? He's commenting and saying the same thing we're saying now. It's these thrones resembles to the world with its business and with its wealthiness and with its desires which we run behind. Okay? So, and Saint Clement saying another saying about the same point. Saint Clement says of Alexandria, saying, we shouldn't blame the money, but we blame the how to use it, okay? The worth of using it, okay? So we shouldn't blame the thing in itself because it's God created it as a good thing for us, but it's a problem if in using it, okay? So even that's about this. So we have to be very careful because all of these points will end to destroy any growth. However, this type had a little more depth. Is that right? It's a little bigger wave affected. But the problem, too many things around us. And this is the issue. Maybe now, while we are very young, we don't feel it much. As you grow older, you feel that everything you was caring and running behind start to lose its depth or lose its, you regret and say, why am I worrying about this? Why I was just spending too much time and effort running behind vapor, nothing. You, with time, you'll realize even our understanding to things with time, you feel it. Your understanding of things when you was 10 differs than when you 20 or when you become 30. Every, as much as you grow, as much your understanding will be different to things. And you realize the vanity of too many things. So blessed is the one who realizes this early in his life. And too many realize this and run away from it. This is what we have, too many monks and too many of this. It doesn't mean that I run, but I have to realize it so I don't worry much. I don't run behind it much. I don't waste my life. And I focus on the right thing. Focus and keep in mind that everything's going. No one is going to stay. Nothing. No money, no relations, no rank, no nothing. Nothing without. So when I stay, the only one stay is how much you are stable in him, how much you are in him. This reminds me for this. And whatever you plant now in your youth, believe me, will save your life when you grow. Because I know many, they were like candles, like you cannot imagine what they were doing in the church. And after time, they lost their way. This every one of us can go through this way. Every one of us can go through that. In a time, you lose your way and you get in doubt and you be away and so on. And then the only thing will keep you what you planted when you was younger. Believe me. I remember this story about Abu Abshoy Kamel. One time they came to him and told him, this man is leaving Christ, and they just deceived him and he decided to go. And many tens and tens of the servants and fathers, they went to him to convince him, my son, you're going in a very wrong way. He was leaving Christ to be, you know, in Egypt. So to deny him and to change his religion and all of this stuff. And everyone tried. No one was able and said, don't try. And he was just closing the door. What happened? Abu Abshoy Kamel went to him. It's written in one of the books of Abu Abshoy. Yeah, I don't know. Yeah, probably some of you know it. And he went to him, Abu Abshoy Kamel, and tried. He opened for him, actually. And he started, Abu Abshoy, to talk, and no answer. Try, my son, are you sure you want to? Said to him, okay. So Abu Abshoy Kamel was going and leaving. His car was downstairs. It was there, and he went down with him. And Abu now going to his car. And says to him, okay, would you like me to drop you anywhere? Yeah, he said to him, yes, yeah, can you drop me in this whatever? So Abu now normally, you know, in the old cars, they have like this cassette recorder, the old one. And when Abu now was putting it on hymns, it was the hymn of Agios Otheos. But very simple hymn, the Agios Otheos, Holy God, Holy Mighty, which we prayed in the liturgy. And once Abu turned on the engine and the guy was jumped in the car. Once in Jesus, it's automatically on this hymn. And the guy, once he heard a ghost of the oath and start exploded in crying. So Abu stopped the car and what happened? He said, for him, I used to. He said, I used to sing this song when I was younger, because he was a deacon. And it was the start to get him back. So believe me, everything you plant in your youth and in your younghood can save you in after. Don't just... So use your flamed heart to build this strong relation with him, because it will save you definitely later, because we all are exposed to lose our ways. We all, no one is strong. We are all weak. The fourth type, which is the good ground. The good ground, it was the difference in it that gave fruits. That reminds me of something which is, can give plants and leaves. It looks wonderful. But when you come closer, you don't find fruits. It's equal nothing. Is that right? The victory. So I'm afraid that we might have all of these leaves, but we don't have fruits. Still, we are not good ground. Still. So the parameter or the main sign is the fruits. Doesn't have to bring people. But this is the problem. We're not going to, like St. Paul says, what? He's St. Paul. He's the one who's done 100, actually. Probably done, yeah, it's, what's more? He's done over the 100 and hundreds. And he's afraid to stand naked. He's saying this. How about us? He's saying, I'm afraid to stand naked. He's saying, but I struggle, so I don't lose my all this what I have done. So he's still struggling and worshiping and repenting. And this St. Paul, how about us? So we need to be careful and we need to work hard. So it's not just our presence in the church. It's good, but it's not enough. It's good to fast and pray, but it's not enough. It's good to give. And all this is just your work and deeds. But it's not enough. Tell me, what is enough? Never enough. But it's all this. It's good to give your tithes. It's gift. It's good to pray. But it's all not enough. But it needs fruits. So what are the fruits of the Spirit? All of them. Love. Joy. Peace. Kindness, faithfulness, all of them. Is that right? This is what we are looking for. The 30 or the 100, 60, and 30. You might say to me, how about if somebody just living his peaceful spiritual life and quiet, this might 30, just working without hearing, even is maybe it's not a servant, it's just living his spiritual life nicely, quietly, without this showing. 30 or 50, there are ones like St. Paul I just mentioned, that's 100. So it's levels, different levels. But the problem is that if we think that we have and we don't, that's a fearful thing. That's the main issue, that we think that we have 30 or 50, and we are one of the rocky or the thrones, just showing leaves. I'm not going to go to the first, okay? However, maybe, but that's the issue, that we think that we have and we don't. And have everyone to ask himself, to be honest with himself. When we continue with the parable, I want to just comment on one verse to end with. Oh my God! Oh, we're late. Okay. okay. So, I wanted just to comment. If you go quick, there is important. Who is moving? Yes. So. Yes, when our Lord Jesus Christ started to explain it to them, they asked him. So the disciples, they came to him and they asked him, well, they want to know what does this mean? Okay? And he started to say, when they hear, can you go back? Yes. Here, so seeing they may see and not receive, and hearing lest they should. And he said, but those who come and pray, can you go a little bit back? Can you move on? Sorry. Anyway, and he started, probably we don't have time to comment on it. But anyway, in conclusion, so we have to be very careful because we might think that we are something, but we're not. Who has will be given more. Who doesn't have, whatever little he has will be taken from. So we have to be very careful. We have who have prayers will be given a response to his prayers. Who has care and trial to be to change will be given. But the one who thinks that he has and doing nothing, whatever this little will be taken from him. So we be careful. Be honest with yourself. We need to be honest with ourselves and find out which type we are. And accordingly, we have to act. And we get back to ourselves and to start to work with the Word. And we trusting. We trust that the Word which makes us stable in Him, the Word of God is very powerful. The Word of God, His Word can raise from the dead. Not only once, but many, many times. The Word of God can raise not only from the dead, but even from the hell, can raise us. But we have to be connected with it. We have to practice it, not just receive it and vanishes like the birds. Because that's what the Satan does. He just grabs it straight. Even when you get, that's the issue. When we're young, you remember. As much as you grow, you will say, when I was younger, any word was affecting me and I can't stop crying. But now I am hearing from here and from there and from Abuna and there's a confession and it's not working. What happened? You lost your sensitivity. In this case, you lost your sensitivity. So get it back. Don't let any time you hear a word and it flamed your heart, let it go. Don't. Run and kneel down and use it and cry and get back and build. Every moment we do this, we build up this spiritual tower inside us, which keeps us safe in Him, keeps us stable, and keeps our steadfastness in Him. So God gave us this inflamed heart to be always connected with Him and stable in Him. And glory be to our God forever. Amen. Sorry for the delay. Still questions? Still? It's 10 o'clock.
No? So, from what you, because like when you hear the parable, you like to think, I don't know, me, I like to think, I'm the good ground. But does that mean if you think that you're actually the first one, the wayside?
Say it again.
If you think you're the good ground when you hear the parable, does that mean you're actually the wayside?
But I need to understand more. So say it again.
Okay. When you hear the parable, if you look at it and think, and you think, I'm the good ground. Does that mean you're actually the wayside one?
No, who said so? No, it doesn't mean this. But it can be, we might be one of the other two because we show some growth, because we count, we do something. So I don't think. But it depends sometimes everyone can know himself. But sometimes you can't see yourself, but sometimes from others around us can see you, can tell you. And sometimes we just struggle in accepting the concept that I am arrogant. And this is stopping me from growth. So I have to accept it and start to work on it. Because I am not going to grow unless I discover the disease or the issue and work on it and treat it. Treat it the right way. So this is cannot come unless you expose yourself totally. First, in your room, in front of him, in the light of the Holy Spirit, will help you, and in front of Abuna, or your father of confession, I mean. So through these two channels, I can realize that there is an issue inside. It has to be treated. And you can feel it from all your experience in your life and God's dealing with you. You can discover what type of ground you are. You know what I mean? All right. It's a big question, but that's a short version.
Any other questions? Queries, conundrums, qualms? I've got other words. What happened to the wayside? That's a good question.
It's a great. How can you fix the wayside then? If you but,
yeah.
I'll tell you, I want to ask this one. It's because I heard one of the beautiful contemplations about this particular wayside. He said it's so tough. It's very hard because it's where all the cows and the cattle just walk in and they're feeding on. So he said, how can you fix this wayside, which is very hard? He said, it needs to be shaken up. It needs an earthquake. You need to pluck it out. That's right. It needs to... It needs to go down a bit because Nadar mentioned a beautiful thing when he said it's elevated a little bit and the ground is here. So you are here, and you're very, very hard and you're very tough. Okay, so what you're going to have to do is someone is going to have to come to you and actually drop you down. And when you drop you down to the same level as the other ground, you can produce. Any drop, any seed that drops on it, you will produce. Why? Because you became very, very soft. The Lord has taken your heart, which is heart of rock, and had replaced it with a heart of soft heart. That's how.
Beautiful. Thank you very much, Deacon. I can't say thank you enough times. And thus we concluded our first talk in our series, Instability versus Steadfastness. And I don't think there's any more like an appropriate parable than to really discuss that when you really think about the nuances of the parable of the sower, the instability, the stony ground, the thorny ground, or even the wayside. A lot of that marked signs of instability. And then you've got the stable, the good ground. So I think it was a great way to kick us off. So I'm going to run through the announcements very quickly. The start of the meeting. Generally, sometime between 8:30 and 8:45 is when prayers and vespers will conclude. We try to get the talk started by 8:45 as much as we can so that we can get out of here by 9:20 at the latest. Sorry that we finished late today. Ha'akumaleya. If you don't know what that means, come find me later. I'll tell you exactly what it means. Now that we've concluded that business, it's really important that we share in the prayers of the vespers, which start at 8 o'clock. The reason that we've made the meeting a bit later was because we found that a lot more people weren't really attending because of how early the meeting start time was. So we've decided to shift it a little bit to give people more of an opportunity. So please encourage your friends, talk about the meeting. Please encourage everybody, to those who did already bring friends, thank you. You know who you are. Please, we'd love to share in the spirit of learning, in the spirit of understanding. We've got Bible study with the Munashnuti tomorrow night. Okay, it starts at 7:45, and the actual Bible study itself starts at 8:00. It is great. It's a very deep dive. Like if you think of depth, the Bunishnuti is very deep, and it's great because it gives us an opportunity to really explore and understand the scripture. We've got the Friday night youth meeting. Okay, that too starts at 8 p.m. And they've got amazing activities that follow the meeting. So I would highly encourage you, if you have nowhere else to be on a Friday night, and even if you think you do, you should probably still show up anyway. With that being said, I think that's about everything I have to say. So can we all stand up for prayer? We'll say a quick hymn, and then we'll conclude with prayer.
the weak say, I am strong in the strength of the Lord.
Hallelujah. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. Oh, compassionate, beautiful God, thank you for allowing us to stand before you. And thank you for these beautiful words about the parable of the sower. How beautiful is your word, dear God, that falls down to different grounds and different souls and react differently. We ask you, Heavenly Father, to bless us all and to bless your words in us. You have said it way to Jeremiah. He said that I have put my word in you. So go and talk. Please, dear God, you have put the words in us. We have just heard beautiful four different grounds, and they're all different, and we're all different, and we react different to your words. Everyone loves the word. Everyone can go singing, can sit with you, can retreat, can read the Bible, can pray, different grounds. But the goal is one. The goal is you. As long as you are with us, as long as you are in our hearts, that is what we need. That is what we want, dear God. Through these beautiful 50 days of the Holy Resurrection, that you have plucked us up from death into life, we ask you, our Heavenly Father, to bless us all, to bless this meeting and all the servants and all the congregation and all the fathers, and through the intercession of St. Mary and St. Mina and the Archangel Michael and the saint of this day, please, dear God, hear our prayers when we all say to you, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, for thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. By the way, there's pizzas at the back, so beautiful. Don't go far away. Just go behind the glass door. There's pizza and chocolate. So go for it.